¿Qué hay así? Presents. When this mother saw her new baby's face, she immediately knew that he wasn't hers. Richard Cushworth and Mercedes Casanellas welcomed their first child, a little boy, in May 2015. His mother had given birth in her native El Salvador before returning home to the United States. However, as she watched her baby grow, she became convinced that he wasn't hers. Cushworth and Casanellas have both known struggles in their lives. For instance, Cushworth had spent some 20 years of his life battling drug addiction, including reliance on alcohol, cocaine, and heroin. But he finally turned things around after attending Teen Challenge, a drug rehabilitation program with a Christian focus. After finding God, Cushworth went to Bible school at the Christ for the Nations Institute in Dallas, Texas. And it was here that they first met Casanellas, who was attending the evangelical organization as a foreign student. The couple married in 2012 and traveled to Casanellas' native El Salvador to work as missionaries. But while the missionary had managed to conquer his addiction as well as find love, his troubles were far from over. You see, while in El Salvador, the apartment he'd been renting in Dallas was gutted by fire, and he lost all his possessions. Meanwhile, Casanellas had survived a gun attack after being set upon by a gang of five shortly before her move to the United States. Eventually, Cushworth and Casanellas returned to the United States, settling in Dallas once more. And in May 2015, the couple were set to become parents, with Casanellas giving birth at a hospital in El Salvador. Interestingly, this was thought of as one of the best private health facilities in the country. And Casanellas delivered her baby via an emergency cesarean. She was handed her newborn son, Jacob, briefly before he was taken to spend the night in the hospital nursery. Recalling that special moment in an interview with the BBC in 2016, Casanellas said, "He was just passed by me and I gave him a kiss and then he was taken to the nursery, and that was the last time I saw him." The following day, nurses returned Jacob to Casanellas, and when he was 4 days old, Casanellas left the hospital and reunited with Cushworth, who'd flown in from Texas. Then, they spent 3 months in Central America before returning as a family to their home in the States. Back at home, as the weeks and months passed, Casanellas and Cushworth bonded with baby Jacob. Yes, his mother nursed and cared for him, but all the while she struggled to shake a niggling doubt from her mind. You see, she felt her baby didn't look like her or her husband, and this led her to wonder whether Jacob was really theirs. In fact, Casanellas' first doubts had emerged in the hospital when Jacob was handed to her the day after his birth. She later told the BBC, "When I saw him, the first impression was, this is not the same baby that I saw last night. I looked him, and I remembered that the baby that I saw was just like my husband, and this baby did not look like my husband." Unsurprisingly, Casanellas raised her concerns to the hospital staff. But they assured her that the baby she'd been given was definitely hers. To further ease the new mom's worries, nurses told her that she'd been heavily medicated. When she'd briefly seen Jacob for the first time, in other words, she couldn't rely on the first memory she'd had of her child. So with the nurses telling the first time mom that the child was hers, she had little choice but to believe them. However, she continued to ask her friends if they thought there might have been some kind of mix-up with her baby, but everyone assured her that Jacob was hers. For the time being, Casanellas tried to put her worries to the back of her mind, but they didn't stay buried for long. In her interview with the BBC, she said of Jacob, "The days started to go by and his features, his skin, everything started to change. And he started not to look anything like neither one of us. Painfully, Casanellas tried to ignore the doubts over whether Jacob belongs to her and Cushworth as much as possible. She even kept her worries from her husband, who had no idea that his wife was wrestling with the idea that their son may not be theirs. Instead, the new mom secretly took a DNA test to get to the bottom of the matter once and for all. And when the DNA results came back, Casanellas discovered that she had a 0% chance of being Jacob's mother. Yes, she'd been right all along. Describing her reaction, Casanellas told the BBC, "I just fell on the floor." Fighting back tears, she also described the pain, the thought that the baby I had been nursing, taking care of, loving him, bathing him, that he was not mine. Eventually, Casanellas told Cushworth about the DNA test and what it had uncovered. Revealing his reaction to the news, Cushworth told the BBC, "I was just overwhelmed and confused. I didn't even know how to process it. I remember the first trauma to me was, oh my goodness. I have a child and my child is somewhere out there in the world. Where is he?" Prior to the bombshell DNA test, Cushworth had no inkling that Jacob may not have belonged to him and Casanellas. He explained, "I just accepted it as my child. Now I look back at the pictures right around the time that we came to Dallas when he was 3 months old. And I'm shocked that I never suspect because you can see that it's just obviously not my child." Using the benefit of hindsight, Cushworth continued, "I don't know how I did ask myself. You don't think about these things." Meanwhile, his wife added, "We were in love with the baby. Even when I did the DNA test, I thought that I was betraying him." However, she added that she simply couldn't live with the doubts she had over Jacob's parentage. The new father told the BBC, "Our hope in the beginning was that we would find our real child, but we would also be able to keep the one that we had raised for 3 months. And that we would have two children was our hope, but I remember that I was the first one that started saying, you know, if this child has a legitimate family, we're going to have to give him away. Therefore, it seemed likely that Jacob had been mistakenly given to Casanellas from the hospital nursery the morning after the birth. So to get to the bottom of the mix-up, DNA tests were carried out on the children who'd been born at the hospital in El Salvador on the same day as Jacob. And that's how Casanellas and Cushworth found their biological child. But the couple's joy at being told their son had been found was mixed with feelings of grief that they would have to give up Jacob, whose biological parents had also been identified. Casanellas recounted how she handed over the child she'd grown to love in her emotional interview with the BBC. As tears fell down her face, Casanellas recalled, "We got there and we had to rush. We were rushed in. We have to go quickly, just bring the baby and we barely got time to say goodbye. I got all his clothes and we took him in the office and we handed him in. And that was the most difficult part, I think, of all the situation. For you see, when the couple swapped Jacob for their son, both babies seemed to slot right into their real families." Casanellas explained, "We didn't know each other, the two families, we don't know anything, but the babies, when we took them and we switched, they each were dressed like their fathers. It was really nice." While the truth behind the mix-up has eluded them, all Casanellas and Cushworth could do was assess the difficulties they'd faced and try to move forward. Cushworth explained, "It's done terrible financial damage and emotional damage to us. But we are here, we survived, everything is turning out okay." Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe!